fear that most people don't know that the sun doesn't set on the same spot on the horizon every day. Because if asked, people say, well, the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. But it doesn't. It only rises due east and sets due west on the equinoxes, March 21st and September 21st. All the other days of the year, it is rising and setting somewhere else on the horizon. And it's systematic. It's not random. Now we look at Manhattan, which has a street grid, a perfectly rectangular street grid, except for Broadway, which cuts as it chooses through the streets and avenues. And generally, we think of uptown as north and downtown as south. However, the grid itself is not oriented exactly north-south. It's rotated about 30 degrees from due north. Combine all these facts, you can ask the question, is there a day of the year where the sun sets exactly along the cross streets of Manhattan? Well, you get this alignment 2 days a year. And for New York City, in our grid, 30 degrees rotated, and all the orientation, it's May 28th and July 11th. Those two dates are sort of equispaced around the summer solstice. And, you know, you read anthropological books where they're always looking at some ancient culture. If they didn't have writing, you have to infer what they valued. And so I thought, an apocalyptic Earth, if there's nothing that survives but our street grid, what would they say of us? Surely, future anthropologists would argue that we arranged our grid to align with the sun on purpose on those days. And what could they learn about our culture? Well, what's interesting about those dates? May 28th, that's around Memorial Day. Okay, that's interesting. What's the other date? I looked this up. That's around baseball's All-Star Break. Memorial Day, that's war. July 11th, All-Star Game, that's baseball. So they would conclude that America was about war and baseball. In my youth, I went on a research expedition to the British Isles to study stone monuments like Stonehenge, but less celebrated and less grand and less preserved. There are tons of them, literally, because these are heavy stones. And so the concept of stones aligning with the cosmos was deep within me for a long time. And so I thought, could there be a good name for this? The city interacting with the cosmos. These alignments are not made of stone, they're made of buildings, and Manhattan is about buildings. And so I just thought of calling it Manhattanhenge. Oh, and I just got a phone call recently from the Oxford English Dictionary. And they want to put Manhattanhenge in the dictionary. I was honored that I would get the call. But even if they didn't put it in, we'd still use the word. Who cares what the dictionary says? Thousands of people flood the streets to look at Manhattanhenge.